Well, that was nesting. The other important addition to state machines that Harel offers is concurrency. In this case, concurrency is indicated by a dashed line. It separates a larger roundtangle into two other machines. But in this case, it is nesting that goes on at the same time. That is, we've cranked up two machines that are running. Each can have their current state, each can respond to transitions, and each can perform actions depending upon the transitions. Okay, once again, this reduces the total number of states from a multiplicative combination to an additive combination. Here's from Harel's paper. On the left is the bowl of spaghetti that indicates the multiplicative combination. Notice the labels of the states are really indicating where you would be in one of the concurrent machines and where you would be in the other concurrent machine. Hard to understand what's going on there. Harel has replaced this jumble by one major state labeled Y and left two of the original states, H and I, to interact with it. The Y state has that dashed line indicating concurrent actions that are taking place. They correspond to states A and D. They each have default states. They each have their own transitions. But hopefully you can see it's a little bit easier to follow what's going on there. Notice also that Harel allows the splitting of a transition to go to two possible states, one in each of the concurrent arms. So the lower right state in the rightmost diagram I has an E transition coming out of it that's then split into two places. There's also an example of a data condition in here as well. In UML, the concurrency looks like the following. There are two states here. There's an idle state and a maintenance state. The maintenance state has the dashed line. In this case, it's a horizontal line, and two concurrently executing machines, one called testing and one called commanding, each of which are quite simple. Each has an initial state and a final state and some transitions between them.